Hello, you two. Look at you and your little bubble. Not in that bubble.
Oh, I've got very great greasy hair today. Well, we've got our cup of tea, so it's fine. How are you?
Well, that's the thing about lockdown, isn't it? Where we didn't have to care about like washing and grooming, and now
I grew a tash and I grew very bushy eyebrows.
Bushy.
Yeah, but now we're out in the public, we have to make an effort. I've been to the gym today. That's how committed I was.
Oh, yay, it's good. Where'd you go?
I did a spin. Digme's ripped face. Yeah.
That's what you do now.
Yeah, I went to Digme a lot on Saturday, did a spinning class.
They're great, aren't they? I'm getting really into
You've
it.
You've been at my old stomping ground at Sweat It.
Yeah. Nice. Machito was on a bike behind me.
Machito?
Yeah.
Oh, bless him. Oh, we love him.
They were all there. Giving it all. How are you both? Are you recovered from last night? So last night you were at Freedom.
We were at Freedom last night. It was the first time that we sang
together. It was so,
together,
so exciting.
Publicly. Yeah, it was fun. Public, did I say that right again?
Publicly,
yeah. Yeah, no, it was lovely to just perform again.
We've been buzzing all day from it, really. It was just so fun, wasn't it? It was really, really good.
It was your Kinky Cabaret debut.
I know. I couldn't believe that. Natalie arranging that on the fly.
I got you, girl.
You've got Britt Lenty, who's a regular, sat in the
exactly.
Good friend, yeah. And then, yeah, it was so fun. I can't believe I've not even actually ever gone to see one, let alone
be one. Yeah, so am I, actually, now.
Yeah, it's really surprising.
Mm. Well, that was where I first got introduced to you, Miss Green.
God, what was it?
Yeah, years ago. I think you were singing a Sia song. I think it was Alive.
Oh, Alive.
Yeah.
That's a good memory.
Yeah. And it was like, that's not an easy song to sing, especially not at 1 a.m. You like rocked it.
Oh, thank you. I'll pay you later for that one, yeah. I'm still breathing. I'm still breathing. That is, and then the last time I saw you, I think before this was at Andrew's gig.
Yes. So anyway, let's talk about your show coming to the Union Theatre.
Very exciting.
Nat and Nat.
Yeah.
Is it? Very, very original.
Yeah, that must have taken a long time to like come up with that title.
Yeah,
we brainstormed. We did brainstorm. We've had so many people saying, you know what would be really good is Green Woods or
Woods Green
or the Natalies. Well, actually, there was a pop group called the Natalies, wasn't there?
That I think
was
so, yeah.
My agent and my mum wanted the Natalies.
Yeah. And then we were like, everyone just calls us Nat and Nat.
Yeah.
And we call each other Nat and Nat.
All the time.
So that's it.
Did you meet at college? Is this right?
Yeah, we met at college. How many years ago now?
Let's not go there.
What was it? 16 years?
Back in the 1800s. Yeah. let's just say that and and we'll move on. No, yeah, we met back at Collins Performing Arts, which was back then was a performing arts college, and they produced some incredible talent from that.
Yeah, they have.
Sadly, it's no longer.
No, it's closed down now.
Oh.
But well, yeah,
legacy about, though for them.
It was about 16 years ago. Me and Nat met, and we clicked straight away.
Nat,
sorry, it would have worked.
Yeah, we were four. I was four when I went there.
And you were a toddler, preschool.
No, I went to college. I was really advanced. Oh dear. Oh,
what do we expect from this show?
Well, we hope some singing, but whether we can get through a song without laughing, I don't know. But we just wanted to bring a little bit of everything. So we've got a bit of musical theatre, a bit of jazz, a bit of comedy.
80s.
Cheeky 80s, because we were born in the 80s, weren't we, Nat?
Look, she just can't drop it, can she? She can't drop it. Do you know what? The biggest giveaway, actually, the website Natalie did really well. She put the website together for Nat and Nat. And she managed to make the website www.natalie1988.co.uk.
Yeah, because otherwise I forget things. It's just simple.
Yeah, and everyone else is not going to forget it now either.
No, yeah, I know.
So is it all going to be songs? Is it going to be a bit of chatting there?
We're definitely going to have a bit of chatting because we love chatting, don't we,
Nat? Do we? Yeah.
And yeah, there's just going to be loads of songs, and we just wanted to bring live theatre, live cabaret and music together.
Because we're light-hearted people, like normally 9 times out of 10. Actually, 99 times out of 100.
Really?
We're in good spirits, aren't we? Yeah, we're lighthearted. Whenever we're in each other's company, because we've worked a festival this year together, like getting people to stay in their booths and ticketing and stuff. And it's normally always fun and lighthearted. And what we wanted to do was incorporate our love of performing. And obviously with this whole situation that's going on, which is just, you know, turned everything upside down, we wanted to put the two together. And because we literally could talk non-stop, we thought, well, let's try and put some songs in there and just be Nat and Nat.
Yeah, and it's all socially distanced. It's all really well organised. So if people are apprehensive of booking, then because of the situation, then it's all safe and there's temperature checks.
Yes, this is in the Union Theatre where they've taken out all the seats. So it's now just cabaret tables.
Yeah.
You've got more space.
She's done an amazing job.
Yeah.
Have you been there yet?
I popped in when they first ripped all the seats out, and I forgot how big the space was.
Yeah.
So awesome. You, of course, did The Fix, which opened that venue.
Yeah. I did it at the old Union.
Right.
Yeah. So it's really weird because I just associate the Union to the one opposite. But I've seen this one grow and grow, and it's just a lovely space. And what you can do with it is brilliant. It's lovely.
Yeah. And it, like you say, they do take it. It's all table service. There's no going to the bar.
No. The people have to wear their masks until they come and sit down. And then they can take it off. And
it's like Kinky last night.
Yeah.
There's everything sort of set in stone as to how you can and how you can't be wearing your mask. And I mean, it's so weird. What is 2020? Yeah. Why are we turning up to a club and the first thing they say is not, hiya, how are you? Or your ID, it's, let me check your temperature. And, you know, what is 2020?
It's like, very weird.
We need to, but yeah, no, it's all very much set in place as to keep everyone safe.
And as you know, the arts, is completely suffering right now. And I don't think people realise how live music, how much we need it.
Yeah.
And we just hope that we're bringing something little to everyone just to have a little bit of a feel of live music back again, you know?
And of course, a pair of you should be in the West End right now.
I know.
It should be like your half hour call.
I know. It's so weird having a Saturday free and a Wednesday or Thursday free.
When was your day off going to be?
Sunday. But we'd have matinees. We'd have matinees on a Thursday.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're talking about, in your case, is Prince of Egypt, which you at least you got it opened and you had your press night.
Yeah, I was really lucky. I got on quite a lot as well just before lockdown, so that was really nice. I was lucky, but we were still in rehearsals for our first covers, and we were still tired from tech and previews and rehearsals, and we were just starting to get into a routine of having a show, you know, up and running. But COVID.
I thought we're quite confident, the producers are quite confident that you were going to be back by November. And obviously they've now had to... ambitious.
I know, bless
them. 2020. I mean, come on.
I remember when that was announced, I was like... Because
yeah,
the really show is fun. So intricate. And obviously the work the ensemble do, is there's no room.
There's no social distancing. I mean, the producers have been amazing and they're doing everything and anything that they can to bring the show back. And
they've kept you informed, haven't they? They've kind of like...
kept us informed, yeah. I mean, there's only so much they can tell us, like everyone. You know, no one has a crystal ball. No one knows what's going to happen in the future. But they do want the show to come back. And I would like to have a job.
You will. You always will. You can be an elf at Christmas.
I know.
And for you, Miss Woods, so you were supposed to be at the other side of the West End.
I know.
In a little show called Hairspray.
I know, it's just so sad. We'd literally, we'd done 2 days of rehearsal.
Yeah.
And which was lovely to meet everybody. We met Michael Ball and, you know, we met everybody and it was so lovely. And then the third day, we're getting told that you know, there's nobody to facilitate the rehearsals. And then obviously nobody was allowed to go to rehearsals.
Yeah.
But our producers were very, very much like, look, and Jerry Mitchell did a video and everything because he couldn't get over. And he was like, look, no matter what, we are going to get this show up and running. We just don't know when. And right. That's been the kind of spirit throughout the whole thing. And obviously the cast has performed on Britain's Got Talent as well, which is cool. It's created such an amazing buzz and everyone's got so excited. And I watched it and I was literally bawling. I'm so proud of them. And they've worked so hard and it's just lovely to see some theatre, isn't it?
Yeah. But again, because obviously they announced early on that you'll be back in September. Again, ambitious. But I mean, so how was it for you when you're kind of getting these announcements and was it up and down, kind of like playing with your emotions, be like, really?
I think the biggest thing I've learned this year is patience is a virtue. And you until you know for sure that something is going to happen, then just take every day as it comes. Like, I'm doing a gig on a Hairspray concert thing on Friday at the Alhambra, is that right? It's terrible, in Leicester Square. And we had a rehearsal today and it's brilliant, but you just don't take it for granted. You just take every day as it comes. So you just learn that way. I mean, what about you, Nat? How did you feel?
It's completely the same. You know, it's like when you get offered a contract, you don't really believe it until you've signed it.
Yeah.
It's kind of the same feeling, but at least there is some, they're optimistic that it will happen. But yeah, we've just got to wait until, like everyone, we've just got to wait, you know, and do what we can.
Literally
until then.
Like all our fingers and toes crossed, being like, please,
you know,
get back.
I know.
I wanted to ask, because I only realised this, you both have something in common. You both played Jam in Greece, is that right?
Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
I didn't tell you years ago now.
What?
Yeah,
that is really weird.
And I had a lunchbox and I put loads of food in it by accident. And then I was just being cheeky. And I dropped the lunchbox on stage and this food went everywhere.
Joker.
You did the European tour.
I did the European tour, yeah. God, that was years ago, yeah.
How did I not know this now?
I don't know now.
That we've had so many things. We've got so many things in common.
Weird.
And to not, we can use that in the cabaret,
yeah.
But you've done it more recently. So you were in the UK tour last year and at the Curve.
Yeah, and then we did a little short stint in Dubai.
Cheating.
Nice.
I mean,
how was that? I've never been, but it looks out of this world.
Literally, like it's a beautiful place. Like it's beautiful, and I mean, it's just stunning. And the venue that we performed at was like an arena, and. But obviously they don't drink over there, so the social life is very different to over here. So
she's like, I can't.
What is this?
Get me home.
Get me home, though. It was, and they were very supportive. And the producers took us on this boat, and like I say, boat, like yacht, like it was crazy. And we're jumping off into the sea, and you know it was amazing. But yeah, Greece 3 times. I know. I'm like, wow.
And was that tour meant to come back? and it's had to be
yes, kind of, yeah. It was definitely coming back.
But you weren't good.
Yeah, no, because obviously I was auditioning for Hairspray at the time, and I just felt that my time with Grease, I loved it so much, and I never thought that I could love a cast as much as the previous one. And every single cast I've taken lifelong friends from.
Yeah.
And I think it's just time to say that one is for now anyway. As another 20 years, you never know. Be a Stana Stairlift singing Mooning. I don't know, yeah. And Hairspray, it's just like, I was like, I'm walking cover. So it means obviously I won't be on stage every night.
Yeah, what does that mean? Because I saw this, but I was like, I don't even know what that is.
So basically, because it's such a specialised role,
yeah,
it's, you can't really have someone that fits the Tracy brief in the ensemble.
Right.
Well, you can, you can't. It's like, I've got a cover as well. So there's two covers within the cast. Obviously, you've got your walking cover. And because it's such a demanding role as well, I'm basically on standby, if you like.
Chilling in the changing room.
I certainly won't be doing any of that. The amount of songs that Tracy sings in that show.
You do make me laugh.
Oh, so I can't perform with her. She's too much.
And I've got another question. So you both have worked with the lovely Ryan Anderson, who was there last night.
Yes, Ryan. I love Ryan. He's a very close friend.
I did Hair with him, and you did Grease with him.
Yeah, it feels like I've known him for about 10 years. Like we're very close friends now, but because we obviously worked opposite each other.
Yeah.
But we ended up sharing digs together, and like, you know, we were always inseparable, like glued at the hip. So yeah, he's playing Pippin at the moment.
I was about to ask, have you had a chance to see him?
I sure have. And no, honestly,
it's stunning. It's so good.
It's so, so good. As is the whole cast, though. That production is just brilliant. Yeah. They've done so well.
Yeah. And the work that that producers have put into that venue, like, they've just got new signage up. It looks incredible.
Yeah.
I'm there again. I'm there this week watching something called Naked Boys Singing.
On Sunday?
Oh.
I'm going on Thursday. Yeah. That'll be interesting.
You just go to that one now.
Yeah, that. It's been a long time.
But speaking about Nick, is that obviously we've got to talk about Hair. Were you the only one that was in all three productions?
I was, yes. Yeah.
They just couldn't get rid of you, could they?
They couldn't get rid of me. No, you know what? It was amazing. The tour was tough, but I had so much fun. And we went to Cologne. In Germany, and it was phenomenal. It was amazing. But each cast has been amazing, and I've just got long life friends from each cast. And it's very, I got naked on stage. It's just so weird thinking about it.
Well, I mean, it was only very briefly, and there were so many of you. Like, I saw it three times, and like, I didn't notice you any time. I was too busy looking at something else.
Did you come to the vaults?
Yeah,
that was very intimate. And we had a
I think I had Adam Dawson lying on my feet at one point.
We didn't care. Once we'd done it once, it was done, and then after that we didn't care. Everything was out. We didn't care. Save me a fortune on a wax.
And you get those often, don't you, Nat?
I do, Nat. But we had a naturist organisation that came to the show. So they called up our producers and said, we'd love to come see the show naked. So she was like, okay, we'll do a late night showing. So at 10 o'clock, we had people come in, and then they
said, how was that? And they say, like, if you ever get nervous, picture your audience naked, but in your case, they literally were.
I didn't know what to do. Well, I had to have a pee because I know what I'm like, and I would have started laughing, and that I would have been gone. First people to sing, you know what I'm like now. Once I'm gone, I'm gone. It's really bad. So I had to have a little look, and I couldn't believe my eyes. And then I went on stage, and then we spoke to them in the bar, and they were like, "Let's just get this out the way, have a look," and.
Did you meet them naked?
I met them naked.
You were naked as well?
No.
You all put your clothes back on?
Yeah, they would. I mean, pardon?
You all put your clothes back on to meet them.
Oh gosh, no,
they didn't.
No, but they didn't. We did.
They chose not to.
I mean, good. I mean, I wish I was like that.
You should have been. You'd have made them feel more welcome now.
I was very friendly.
Maybe this is something you can do for your show.
Well. Yeah. Oh well, nah, show it. No, I'm joking.
Could you imagine the reactions of the audience?
No, my dad is watching. God, oh god.
Your dad was there last night taking tequila shots.
My dad was there at Freedom last night. He's 66 soon, and he was doing tequila shots. He's a legend.
Absolutely. Wow.
Bless him.
He wasn't the guy with the dog, was he?
No. Bless him. That poor dog. If anyone's watching, there was a dog in Freedom last night, and it was quite loud, and I felt
it was, sorry. It was a little access dog, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was gorgeous. Oh, hello.
So you've got something else coming up, A Night at the Musicals.
I do, yes. I can't believe it.
Queen Theatre, Hornchurch. Tell me about this. This is, and it's been extended now. You're doing two nights.
Yes, potentially three. I'm not quite sure. I think that's still talking, but... Carly Tons and Max Reynolds is producing it. Hornchurch is a local theatre and actually means quite a lot to me because all the stage schools that I've been to when I was younger, we always did the shows there. So it's quite nice going back and just live theatre, well, live theatre as it can get, and just, you know, singing again.
But and Max was Max your resident director on
there? Lovely, yeah. And on tour as well. I'm really excited to work with him again. Excited to. I actually went to stage school with Carly, so I haven't seen her for a little while. It's just lovely, yeah. And I hope it'll be nice. I'm sure it will.
Yeah. What type of music and songs are you going to be singing then? Is it going to be things from your careers or?
Well. A bit of both, I think. There's some songs that we just like singing or shows that we want to be in. Some shows that we have been in.
Our cabs. Yeah. Sorry.
The cab that we're doing next week. Next week.
Dear, sorry. So we're doing a combination of songs like, oh, you're frozen, darling. You're frozen. You're not frozen anymore.
I'm here.
Yeah, basically, we're doing a collection of songs, like Nat said, shows that we've been in or would love to be in, or just songs that we maybe would never sing. And it's just anything that makes us feel good, that we think the audience will enjoy. And
we've got a few little crazes up our sleeve, haven't we? Some interesting numbers with a twist to them, haven't we, Nat?
We do, yeah.
But we don't want to give that all away.
Are you doing anything from Wicked?
I'm not, no.
I know.
But I am singing something from Wicked at the night, the musicals in Hornchurch. So I'm singing something from Wicked.
Well, there you go. So if we've got any Wicked fans who followed you around the country.
Yes. But any requests, let us know and we'll see what we can do.
See if we can pull something out of our sleeves.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Well, for you, I mean, you can pull something out of the Wind and the Willows.
She was making me laugh the other day. I was like, she was leaning over. I was like, Nat, what are you doing? She was like, you know, when you were back. Pretending to be the back of the horse and you were showing me what you were doing.
The back of the horse? No, I was the front of the horse.
Front of the horse.
I was the back of the cow in Gypsy and then I was the actual horse. There wasn't any back end. Because we do, you know, Nat and I share that in common. We love to play animals.
Yeah, well, I played a goat. You played a cow and a horse. I mean...
Oh, wait, and a stoat. I've played a stoat. So, yeah, I was a stoat. And a mole. No, not a mole. No, not a mole. Of course it wasn't a mole. That was Craig Mather. A foal. No, not a foal. I can't even. Just let's. I can't.
Gone.
I was another animal.
I'm gone.
Oh. Amazing. Anyway, moving on. So, when you've been in human form, you popped up recently in Godspell.
Oh, yes. Oh, God. That was the most surreal experience ever because I had not a clue what was going to be shown in Godspell. I didn't know what was going to happen. And all I knew is that I had recorded in front of my phone and that was it. But my first recording, they're like, the sound quality is not good. Okay. I don't really know what you want.
Did you do it in your bathroom?
No, I didn't do it in my bathroom, but you know I love a bathroom.
Yeah, exactly.
Just acoustics, come. But they were like, no, we need to like flat sound. I was like, right, my room is flat sound. Didn't work. They're like, we don't know what to do. I was like, well, why don't I sing in my boiler? So the boiler is in my cupboard in my room, and I padded. It's got like a little shelf, and I took all the towels out and padded them around, and I was singing in my cupboard, I just couldn't believe what was happening. I love that.
I'm gonna go back and watch it and like have a whole different take on it.
About five hours to get it right when it was hot, and I was sweating, trying to sing day by day, belting my boobs off, and I was just, oh God. But it happened, and it was
the end product, I must say.
It was great.
Michael Quinn produced it. Phenomenal.
Yeah.
So good.
Yeah, Michael Strassen directed it. And
it was his conception, wasn't it? His idea to kind of how they wanted to do it.
I thought it was beautiful. I really did. And I thought the quality of it was stunning. And it's amazing what you can produce when you're all in lockdown.
Yeah.
It was pretty special. Day by day.
And they're talking about doing a live production. And they did the drive-in, which was like so live. You popped up on a big screen.
I know, it's so funny. My friend messaged me going, hi. I was like, where am I? Where are you?
Where am I? What? But yeah, I think they're planning to try and get it into a theatre next year, which would be exciting.
Fingers crossed, yeah.
I mean, you might not be available, but...
Hey, who knows? But
now we're going to Broadway, so
we might not make it. No, I'll call my agent, get me a flight over.
Amazing.
Oh, thanks. How are you? Are you okay?
I'm well. Yeah, not bad. I'm currently in my brother's attic. He's got like a leaky skylight which keeps dripping. I'm a bit worried I'm going to get flooded. Can you imagine? Just sit here.
Grunge. Oh, can't say that. Oh God. Yeah,
it's fine. But it's Bake Off tonight, so I'm excited for that.
Oh, yeah, oh God, I need
to. Do you love Bake Off?
No, I wanted to get into it and I didn't.
I can't. And I know people will watch this and they'll go, are you well?
But we would love it. I think we'd love it. We should watch it tonight.
Yeah, definitely. Are you locked down together now? Are you like?
So what's happened is Nat has moved near to where I live.
Right.
So now we're inseparable. We're back to what we were like at college. But the thing is, we're trying to organise this gig, our cabaret, and every time we get together, me, don't we? And we don't stop. So we're like, right, tonight is the night where we're going to work.
If we do 5 minutes of work in a 3-hour session, that's productive.
Very good.
I love that.
And do you have a musical director you've not mentioned?
Flynn Sturgeon, yes.
Yes.
Oh, little Flynn. He's like a little toddler. You just want to sit on your knee.
He's an absolute sweetheart, and hopefully we'll have a rehearsal with him next week.
We're having a meeting with him literally after we speak with you today to discuss, because he's wonderful. He's putting together, so we've obviously given him some sheet music. He's got some himself, and he's putting together. We've also got a bass player and drums as well. So we're going to have a nice live sound, you know, live
music.
And Flynn's just brilliant. He's been so accommodating.
Accommodating.
You're right, Nat.
She hasn't even had a drink yet.
No, he's brilliant. His arrangements sometimes are so, so good. Yeah, very creative.
Are you going to come?
Oh, my dear. I don't know which date. 23rd, 24th. Ooh, spoiled the choice.
No, let us know. We'll sort you out.
Are you doing a live stream?
We're hoping to. We've had a few little complications, but potentially.
It's a tough one because it's... To do a lot, we want to get good footage, obviously, because we'd like to be able to do this more and more and more. And, you know, we don't want to compromise that by doing a live stream. We also don't want people to have any issues with the live streaming. So I think it's very much we're just looking into and if it works out, then yes, we'd like to, ideally.
And if it doesn't, it makes it's special for those that were there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Exactly. Absolutely. And is Friday sold out yet?
No, Friday is then. There's still a few seats left.
Saturday we have sold out.
Yeah, Saturday is sold out.
But yeah, Friday the 23rd, we still have quite a... Well,
I think that's four or five
tables. That's it. That's fine.
Get well at heart.
I know. Get him. Plug it.
Amazing. Right. Well, lovely to see you both, and I will see you on the night.
Oh, amazing. It was so lovely to see you.
I'll be there with my wicked jumper being like, sing it, Defying Gravity.
Hopefully she'll play the role one day and you can come and watch her do it. We'll be in the front row.
One day, oh God, please God. If theatre ever comes back,
paint her green. Oh dear.
That is lovely to see you both.
See you later.
Take care.
Bye.
See you later.
Bye. Bye.